Okay, so here we are on April 18th. And I was out looking at the pond, and what do I see in here? But if you can look at the center of the screen, you'll see a little newt flailing its tail in there among the substrate. This is a freshwater pond in the state of Pennsylvania, northeastern United States. These newts are everywhere. This one's swimming along. You can tell by his thick hind legs there that this is a male. And they're kind of interesting. I thought I would just share with you since I happened upon them anyway. We've had a lot of rain recently, snow recently, and the weather's finally breaking. But these are pretty durable amphibians. Amphibians, as you may already know, have to go to water in order to reproduce, and that's what this guy's here for. He's looking for a female. And lots of grassy bottom here. The water's nice and clear. This is spring fed. This pond is 14 feet deep. And they're just scrounging around along the water's edge here. And all you have to do is sit really still and they'll start moving around and you'll notice them. If you move, they'll dart down into the grass and disappear. Now you might think these things aren't very old. I mean, this one looks like he's about 3.5-4 inches long maybe. But here we go. Here's a female, nice big fat one. She's got two males already clasping onto her. She's the one with the pale yellow. She's nice and thick. This male is kind of passing through. He decides he doesn't want to get involved here. Of course, they reproduce externally there, and she will lay her eggs, and then they'll be fertilized by these males, and that's what they're doing. They're just flailing their tails around and hoping to be there when she produces those eggs. In fact, they're not going to let her go until she does it. So I thought I would share that with you. They are kind of interesting. Now, how old do you think they are? These things actually go through several phases. When she produces her eggs, they're going to look like little tadpoles, but when you look at them up close, you're going to see that they're nice and long and pretty dark in color, and they'll have little gills, so they're going to start their life off in the water, but then they're going to leave the water when they grow their hind legs. They start off with just four legs, and then they're going to leave the water, and you may have seen orange versions, little red-colored ones, and we call those EFTs, E-F-T. And that's when they spend their time on land, and they can do that for many years. Up to 7 years, they may be roaming around in the woods and the wetlands. And after we get done looking at this group here, I'm going to take you up into the woods, and we're going to look around to see if we can't find one of their land phase newts here, which would be red or orange in color. This tail flailing is characteristic of the mating. Usually the males are doing it. In this case, the female looks like she might be trying to break free there. And when they do produce eggs, if I can come back and find those, I'll try to share that with you. I'd like to show you what the developing tadpole phase looks like. She's rolling around. She'd like to get out of there, you can tell. These guys are not looking at, look how thick she is. She's obviously got lots of eggs to produce there. And she's good size. She may actually be anywhere from 12 to 15 years in age. They only get up to about 5 inches in length, so they're really not big. But that underbelly really makes them conspicuous. Why do you think the fish don't eat them? Or the birds, for that matter, or crawdads? They have something called Tetrodotoxin, and that means that they're going to be unpalatable. Nothing wants to eat them. They taste terrible. And that's why such a fragile little amphibian can be so conspicuous. Often they even leave the water, especially during rain, and nothing eats them, but still, only about 2% of the fertilized eggs are going to reach adulthood. So they're plentiful, though. They're not at risk or in danger. And this shows the adjacent habitat. We have some wetlands here, and this is all on my property. Little spring water running through here. I thought I would try to find the red phase, but all I found was this slug here. Turned over some logs. You can find them in humus, usually after a rain on a warm night, although they're cold hardy. Here's a millipede scooting along here. Not at all what I'm looking for. There goes a beetle underneath that. These rotted logs are great places to find newts because they're in there looking for the bugs that they eat. They eat worms, they eat crustaceans, they have a pretty good appetite, and they're good at hunting things down, so they're on the go. And they survive cold winters. And here's a little, I uncovered this spider, I'm sure she's very happy. There, you can see part of her web there. Nope, she's flipped over. Not as happy as I thought she was. In just a second, she scooted right off around the log there. Now we're back to the water. I did not find what I was looking for, and of course, here we are. Here's another male cruising around looking for a mate. And all you have to do is get near water, and they can be found in rivers, lakes. In this case, it's a pond. They like the slower moving water, especially where there's undergrowth like this. Sit still for a while and see if you can't spot some. Thank you for watching this today. I think it's neat to see amphibians, and I hope you have something interesting near where you live. This is an overview of the pond. I'll be sure to update you if I can find those eggs. But for today, sorry to let you down. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more. Have a great day.